What did that used to say, Ian?
It used to say design, build, and program robots with help from mentors and coaches.
Yeah, we didn't like that part so much. I don't think it's too noticeable. Anyway, so...
Alright, so this is the max height, so we have to be able to have at least three linkages, because 18 plus 18 is definitely not, whatever this is, it's more than 36.
Yeah, it should be fine. So then, are we flipping?
Well, if we flip, we need to have as those three linkages. We would need to have something where, now we can use those hinges or whatever, so we would have something where... This is the top one right here. This is the bottom one. This is the center one. And we would have a hinge that hinges across these two.
Yeah.
And then when this folds over, there would be a piece sticking out right here. And then this whole thing would fold up. There'd be a piece sticking out like that, and the hinge part.
So
would be
basically,
right here.
It'd be like hold one of them. That's your base. It'd be like this.
Yeah.
I feel that's, like, that's only two linkages, by the way.
Not
hinges. Sorry, yeah. That's different.
But see, you could do that. You could pull it off where it goes across.
I think you could, but I think it'd be really, really difficult.
Also, one thing about flipping is that if there's something like in the way, and we are like, okay, we're deploying our thing now.
Well, we deploy it.
We have to deploy it like from the thing or something.
It's that first thing. Yeah, that you do in autonomous.
Yeah.
It's that might literally make going down the ramp kind of sketchy. But.
I think we can do it at that bottom.
I don't think elastic would work though, because it'd be like,
I agree.
And like the timing belt would go flying. The hopper, I have no idea where the hopper is.
Well, no, that would all be at the bottom. That would all be at the bottom still.
Yeah, but even so, the timing belt would like. I think it'd just
that's
be really
I don't want to use the motors. For I don't want to lose them.
Okay, so
transmission.
Brilliant.
Here's another option. If we had, let's pretend like these are telescopic.
Okay, I have an idea, but can you talk?
Let's pretend that these are telescoping, not skeletoping. We could have string coming out of them.
Yeah.
And have like special little holes or little, a track inside of it.
Yeah.
That all three of these are based on the. Or they have a surgical tubing or something like that to spring load them.
So for raising it, what do you guys think about massive counterweight that only goes from 18 inches?
Yeah.
And then it's geared.
I was thinking the pulley system, the gears.
No, it would be a pulley system, but you'd have to have some gear so it would go high enough. So it'd be really heavy weight. Not to mention, that would be a great counterweight.
Yeah.
But that would be a great way to have weight in the bottom of a robot. So at the beginning of the match, before we go down the ramp, because that would not be good, it lowers.
I have a feeling it wouldn't be able to do it. I think there'd be too much friction, even at like 15 pounds, I don't know.
Okay, so remember at State there was that one robot that had the little brass telescoping thing?
Yes, I do. There you can hang, they're really short.
If we use something along those lines where a telescope like that...
I don't think that'd be strong enough to
get
cars.
Yeah, I want strong. Here, hang on.
The thing is, we can make that whole system really light. Because in the first place, the playing element is really light. We don't have to have a servo up there if we use some sort of trigger based thing.
Yeah, but that's more of a plan for how we would do it if we didn't have the elevator system.
Well, no, even with the elevator system, launching it up, we can make this whole system really light so we don't have to worry about. We don't have to worry as much about jerk in the robot and that type of thing. It's light. Also, another thing to consider is super flexible, some heights you could flex into the bare metal thing.
That's interesting. I wonder if we could flex it. That's probably
what we use sketchy. A tail whip style thing.
And we just use a giant spring. It could go boing, 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 boing.
That'd be really floppy. That would be bad.
We'd miss all the balls. Okay. I don't have this planned out, but we need a lot of drawer slides, but we have...
Well, we have one.
We got two others, but two out of three are broken. We've got two sets, kind of parallel to each other.
Yeah,
about that
sort of first-year style.
And then we have a curved... Okay, I don't have this planned out. A curved, C-shaped thing The telescope's all the way up to the top. And then, so this is kind of like one half, and there'd be another half here. And then one side, somehow we have a conveyor,
yeah, that's interesting. I think
zip ties plus, or maybe not zip ties.
Are you talking about a timing belt? 18-inch long, like, tube part that's
longer.
C-shaped?
It'd go all,
like,
the way
it'd go all the way to the top.
Yeah, no, it'd kind of be like a half of a telescoping thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, two half, like a telescoping tube cut in half, and yeah, two halves.
The thing about that is, how do you get, you still have the problem with the chain, or the timing belt.
Timing belt. Yeah, no, you would, I know.
And honestly, I don't think that would be any better than just doing an elevator, and it wouldn't be any, it'd be more difficult.
Well, the thing would be that...
Although you would have a continuous thing, so you wouldn't have to have a car. That's interesting.
Yeah, it'd basically be continuous, so even though you'd be watching to make sure you don't pick up five, if you did it right, by the time you picked up the fifth,
anyway,
one might have been dumped already. Oh. And then you would just be dumping as you're driving around.
Yeah, I like that idea. That's a pretty ideal situation.
Here's another situation that could work.
Yeah.
If we are using even a timing belt or a string, it doesn't matter.
Yeah.
If we have some sort of spool where it's offset from the center, so the center, when we're raising the hopper, at the bottom it's slightly slow, and then it just speeds up like crazy in the middle and slows back down.
Whoa.
Like
we were going to do last year, almost. With the,
yeah, but why does it slow down?
Varying diameter.
So then it doesn't, shake things around as much?
I don't think we really
do. I don't think that's the problem. We also have limit switches.
Yeah, this year we're doing limit switches, not stupid encoding. Anyway.
There's got to be wires going to the top. That's a given, because we have to release the thing.
Yeah.
I think that...
Unless we do what I was talking about and we...
Shoot.
No, but even then...
Even
yeah,
then, let's say we're not.
Yeah, we'll need right, some wires. Pretty normal.
Well, so I say, if we're talking about the ideal situation, I say we forget about just like an elevator car, and we try and make it better about the good elevator. We pretty much face the same design problem.
Yeah, but the reason I say that is I bet you could gear it up by like five.
Yeah, I mean the balls
it would be
light,
like whizzing
it
around.
It wouldn't be any slower than the elevator. It'd probably be faster actually, because you wouldn't have to carry more than one. So
yeah,
you could really make it go.
Yeah.
The problem is building. Oh, no, the problem isn't building it. You know what? Because you know what you can do with those. Oh, yeah. Why didn't you think about this?
Brilliant. We're done.
Yeah, we're good. You know, you don't have to have it be all one thing. If it just folds up, you can just have three different sections of chain and three different conveyor belts that all operate independently.
This one yours?
That's true.
No.
That's actually mine. I found it on the ground in the soccer field, and so I just, kind of picked it up.
That's
Founders Couch.
Let me go cut something in half.
I'm sure it is.
But just...
Because I'm visualizing right now.
Yeah.
Essentially, it's the what Ian was saying about the two halves of the tube, and they would telescope out separately.
Yeah.
Just to make it so we can manage wires and that type of thing easier. We could do an entire tube, but that would be harder to control.
Yeah.
And these tubes would be pretty much made out of the same material as the tower tubes are made out of, something clear, something nice would look nice, but also it's really light, and that's the idea, and then those are supported on the back with a piece of carbon fiber or something like that, and then inside of that you have the conveyor belts, and they don't really have anything but like little flaps.
Conveyor belts plural?
Well, on one on either side to make it so it gives pressure and pulls it up faster.
You could probably get away with one on it.
You could, but
oh,
it would be more reliable.
Well, no, hold on. Here's a question about conveyor belts. Will they handle two different sizes of ball? Probably. Give them rigid things. Here's another question. If they have rigid flaps, what do they do when they get to the other side? We just have the back open?
Yeah,
see,
or...
with conveyor belts, I really think we should have... I really think we should have it unfold if we do conveyor belts, not telescope.
Oh, here's an idea. I don't know how exactly the mechanics would work behind this, but if they're rigid body, we have something that runs along the back of the along the back of the conveyor belt to hold them in place.
Yeah.
And then once they get over to the other side, they can flop like that.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm not really worried about. I'm sure we can figure that out. But, like I said, I think if we do conveyor belt, telescope, I think it makes way more sense to unfold than it does to telescope.
Yes.
The only thing is...
Yes, exactly.
Logistics
Perfect.
Of unfolding are a little bit
too. Yes,
also, so here's what I'm envisioning right now.
This one would be smaller, right? Just slightly. And
well, Depends if we're telescoping or folding.
I would say, let's fold, let's only have one side, and so it's gonna be like this.
Yeah, there's only one timing belt on one side.
Yeah, but big arm, and then it just has the mechanism just attached to it.
What mechanism?
Here's the bit. It just looks like this, it's just all attached. And then another one's here, and then I'm not exactly sure how it'd snap up, because this is going to make unfolding a little bit trickier, but I'm sure we could engineer something so it has a little gap, and then it unfolds like that,
here,
and
hold.
Then it unfolds like that.
These two, as if, you know...
But I don't think we need two sides, necessarily.
Well, we have two tubes.
Okay, I don't know how this would work. Huh.
That's interesting.
That would be tall enough.
And then we just have three separate...
And if... Oh, that'd be sweet if
we could do that on both your sides.
That would be so cool.
That would be the coolest thing ever.
Yeah.
Alright, Doris, wait. That's a dumb idea, because then we still have to get the timing going.
Yeah. Or we could just do it on one of the sides. But honestly, I think that would be so cool.
Or on both sides, and have it so when we pull on the when the timing belt starts going, it pulls them up. We could probably do that if we can.
Yeah, that's... There is some way that we could do that.
Yeah.
Like...
And it reverses and it opens.
Even
have
the timing belts like each folded hand. If this hinge right here, this probably wouldn't work. Like runs this timing belt and then it runs this one and then it runs this one.
Just
when
have
they
a
hinge
bit of
up, they're all actually like connected.
We could have it ratchet if we needed to.
Yeah.
I
like that.
This requires CAD.
I'm gonna go do some CAD.
Okay.
Here's the thing I think.
Is that okay? I mean, I don't really have anything.
Yeah,
no, that's fine. Here's the one thing I think though. Let's have the bits that extend, and then let's have them have a cover that's attached. Let's not have two separate things that come together.
There's string somewhere around
you know
on the table.
I mean? So let's have the support structure, which will be carbon fiber or acrylic or something, and plastic gears maybe, and then
it's lighter.
Yeah, okay.
We can make
timing belts,
those are light.
Literally everything we can make super light.
Yeah.
We could even
carbon fiber.
We could mill the timing belt or timing belt the timing.
the timer,
no.
You don't need to mill it. You're gonna 3D print it. That'd be really light.
Anyway, though,
you can make a support.
We have the back structure, and then we just have something that goes along this side to hold it in.
Yeah.
And then we just have it unfold. I don't think we should have like separate things
for each side.
Yeah.
Here's a question. How is this whole system going to then be able to
think about the top?
The hopper would have to be attached to the one that's at the very top.
Well, no, we... yeah, but...
Or not the hopper, but some sort of stopper. And then if we needed
hopper,
a stopper... Well, actually...
18 times 3 is 54.
See, no, what I was thinking was, this would be in the center of the robot,
really
right?
Close, but it would be high enough. It's possible to engineer it so it would just be, like... Three sections would.
Because you know what? We don't actually need something to stop it at the top. Because if it's not in the right place, we could just stop the conveyor belt.
No, but then we'd only have one in there.
I kind of like the idea of a hopper.
We want that gathering
hopper. I like the hopper, yeah.
And plus, we can swing it.
Yeah, I agree. That is going to take some structural things, though.
Yeah.
We could use a small. If we were able to pull this off right, we could use a small servo.
Well,
like
okay.
One of those
how about
little
this?
Micro servos.
How about
to control this so it's lighter?
There are bits on each part.
Well.
So imagine little bits that are attached to this, and let's say there's another thing here, and they slide on like a little track. And once it gets here, they're gonna go click, and these two little rails will slide down.
Yeah,
that's what Levi was talking about.
Sorry,
that's awkward. Anyway, you guys wanted to do CAD. I think this is a really, really solid. I think we're onto something.
This is the complicated idea. Your bike? Okay, go into, go in that door, and
but
left
I
the door
think
to the garage.
It's somewhat doable.
And then press the big white button, you'll find it.
She needs it.
That would be so sick if we could do that, though.
I feel like that's a nuclear option. We don't have the problem. Last year, a conveyor belt wasn't a very good idea because they'd be spaced out incorrectly.
And blocks are heavier.
Yeah. But this year, since we're going to be towing the goal around, of course, this whole idea depends on towing the goal around. If we can't do that, then this idea's out the window.
Well, we're definitely towing.
Well, no, it still wouldn't be an issue.
Yeah, it sort of is. Because...
No, we still want them to get them up.
We have a hopper.
For pickup, that means for pickup that we're just picking up five as fast as possible, right?
Yeah,
we're not sorting.
No.
Ideally...
We can talk about sorting later, and I think sorting will fit into this infrastructure.
Because what if we have the hopper at the top where the hopper has like a little ramp thing where the first part is the smaller tube.
Yeah, it's easy. The hopper is sloped down, and it has a big part, and then
smaller
part, smaller part, two servos.
Yeah, I know, but what's the point of that? You pick up five, chances are it'll be, say, like, two big balls, three small balls. You sort them, but you still have to dump them all out.
Yeah, I know.
So you dump the two big ones out at
and
first.
Then the, and then the small one. Yeah, that's ideal.
Probably just a little bit.
I think we should have that functionality. I don't know if it's going to actually be
mean anything. Yeah.
But I think we should have the functionality. You know, sooner or
sooner.
So we... epic if we can pull it off.
Yeah, seriously.
Like, I don't think any other team will have anything close to this.
Yeah. If teams are going to do, like, a FUFA style or linear slides.
Yeah. I worry about pulling a swerve. Let's not take this robot apart until that one works.
Yeah.
But I do think, honestly, I don't think this is too unbelievably complicated, honestly.
Yeah.
I think it's not actually, like...
I think if we just have one timing belt and we make sure we have a cover on it.
Well, then I don't... three sections that mesh.
And if they're just like zip ties or whatever attached to the timing belt, yeah. It can fold up however it wants in the beginning, and when it snaps out, it'll be like normal.
Yeah. It should work.
Yeah. We also need to make sure it's very durable because it's plastic, it's raising high. We need to make it so it's easy to fix parts of it, just remove parts and put new ones in.
The other interesting thing about this competition, and I know this is totally cheating, but there are going to be a lot of flimsy lifts raised high. What if we have some, what if we do have some sort of part on a robot that has another purpose, maybe it's an autonomous arm, that happens to reach out 6 inches in front of our robot, and it's sturdy enough. And oh, if we happen to, or if a robot comes under us,
it can't come under us.
Or comes and tries to, then we're gonna knock whatever they're raising, and they'll be,
Yeah. Okay, so, we have the two slides like this.
Yeah.
I was thinking zip ties would go like, in here.
Yeah.
And we'll just have bunches of them, I think. We don't, or should we just have a constant?
Constant would be better. It's always annoying to have it at the bottom and there's not, nothing there.
Yeah.
And
I agree.
Actually, it could be like every,
I feel like your half is better.
I guess at the bottom, it'll just be kind of like this conveyor belt going here, and then we'll have one kind of, actually just like a wheel
See,
at the top.
The difference between this and conveyor belts that were used in the past is they used Tetrix parts. And they used Tetrix-based conveyor belts.
And
that
the game pieces were heavy.
Yeah.
Yeah, but, okay, really quickly.
Yeah, they used tank treads with them.
We have...
And they had it so it only fed into it. They didn't have something to dump it after.
This is the bottom of the lift.
Yeah.
The gear that's the timing belt is on is right here. This is curved. We just have a big brush like this.
Yeah.
That would easily feed them into it.
The only
really
question
simple.
About that is that's only one side.
We can do it too fast.
Like
we can do two of them.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Like, try and pick up from both sides?
Yeah, is better, but...
Is it, though? Because if there's a huge pile of... We're just going to be driving, dumping.
I know.
We shouldn't have to turn a lot.
I know, but let's say the goal gets pushed... So, well...
No. We also need to make it so it has... What I think would be good is the thing that picks up the... tower.
Yeah.
We have one on each side, the front and the back, even though there's a pickup on the front.
We were talking about on the sides.
I think maybe we should just do it on the back, since we're not going to grab on the other.
But if we do it on the back, then we're just having one front pickup. And I honestly would be fine with that. I think that's not a bad solution.
Yeah.
And it makes it so it's easier for us to get through things if we go like that, as opposed to this big thing with stuff on the sides.
I would agree with that.
I'm going to pick up all this stuff, as opposed to...
I don't think two pickups is going to be out of place.
Here's one thing.
It's not really going to be out of place.
Here's one thing, though. What if a robot... I doubt our grappling thing is going to be very strong. Like, honestly, I just don't think it would be.
Grappling thing?
It's a hook onto it. So, robot drives up, bangs into the tube.
Oh, no, there's little holes in it.
Oh, yeah.
In the base.
Oh.
If we could hook into those holes.
Yeah. Basically, what I was thinking was under like our robot, we just have like an angle that's
the shape of it,
and then 72 like some
degrees,
sort of thing that locks in.
And then when you press into it, it can even hit a touch sensor, and we lock down because the holes will be in the right place.
Yeah.
This whole thing could go. It could fold out, deploy like that at the beginning of the competition with a little locking mechanism.
Yeah.
So it goes like that, and then it's on like a rack and pinion with a servo, and it just goes down.
Yeah.
And with like two little pins.
I think it makes more sense just to go through.
One thing about this nuclear option is that the judges aren't going to be able to count how many balls we have. So we might start to
make it clear.
Yeah, if we make it transparent, like the towers.
Well, yeah, but...
Honestly,
I mean, yeah, we could make the argument, but if it's all clear, they're going to be like, 1, 2, 3, oh crap, they're moving. They're going to be trying, like, counting all the balls, like, in the pickup and the lift.
So?
Yeah.
And for us, that might be hard, too.
That doesn't matter, because if we're not breaking rules, then it's not an issue for us.
But how do we know? Like, I think it's going to be difficult to tell. We have five.
I know. Does that play to our advantage, or does it screw us over with our face? That's a good question. Maybe we can.
I mean, I still think this is faster than a lift, though. So, I mean, pick up five, zip them to the top, and dump them, and do it again and again and again. Yeah. Then it's clear we're only picking up five.
Anyway, the deal with autonomous.
Okay, so it's going to be impossible to score in your own autonomous goal because whatever they do, they can just come in and push all of your bowling goals away.
We've still did a program for it.
But you are allowed to score in your opponent's rolling goals and still get points.
Really?
Yes.
What?
Well, basically, you can score in any rolling goal. The specific wording is any rolling goal.
Wow.
So the easiest thing to do would be to go there, move all of them, but dump yours in the smallest one first because that counts for the least points.
Yeah, okay.
And then get to the center and do the stuff.
That's brilliant, actually.
And, like, move all their stuff.
So, okay, here's what we do. And we need tracking wheels for this.
Yeah.
Unfold giant thing. You don't know about that yet. It'll be sick if it ever works. Drive down ramp. Tracking wheels.
Actually, no. Fastest way would be to start from the park.
You're right. Okay. Unfold. Drive. Score the first one, and then keep driving and push everything. Tracking wheels tell us where we are. Mm-hmm. Turn, shirk, score.
Yes.
Okay. That'll work.
Score center.
Okay, Levi.
So, yeah, what is your plan?
I'm just looking at different hopper shapes because I think that just a straight up two. Yeah, we're going to need to change the angle of this. But
well, what if, no, just make the end more tubular.
More tubular? Yeah, well, no, I'm talking about, like, changing the angle.
Oh, now I see what you're
saying. But this would make it a lot easier to fit things in low profile.
Yeah, I think this is actually looking like a good idea.
That's what I'm worried about.
We're going to have to figure out exact shapes of it, but dynamics behind it would work. It's a small opening, and it's not the right shape.
Yeah. One thing you're wondering about, Ian.
What?
What were you wondering about?
Well, it was just exactly that, but there's a possible way for multiple balls to jam.
Yeah, I think jamming is pretty likely. But maybe not as likely. It's not as likely as it with balls as it was with
boys.
Yeah, it's actually, they're kind of weird to juggle. And, well, no, put them all in.
So, with this funnel.
Here, I'll hold this.
I don't.
Wow.
What?
Yeah, we'd have to really rethink the shape of it. But something where if they stack up like that.
Next, my question is when the robot does this gonad.
Get jammed?
Yeah, it keeps on getting jammed because it's exactly, this diameter is exactly the diameter of two of them. If we just changed it a little bit smaller, then it wouldn't happen. So we can move this in.
Okay.
But Levi, where on the robot does this go?
Right in front of the pickup.
Wait, where's the pickup?
This is the tower.
Okay. And we got it right here, but obviously it wouldn't stick out this far because this is way too
long. So it'd sweep them into this big vertical thing, and then this thing would go like that.
And get into the far linkage again. That's not a bad strategy.
Put those balls in again.
Doesn't work. Let's see how big it is.
Also,
is that all five?
Yeah.
This thing would be on some sort of servo, so if it did get jammed, we could do a little bit of jiggling. Not a great.
I don't know if I'm going to finish this thing lazy, but just so we know like how big it's going to have to be.
Not a great solution, but it is something to think about.
See, like, I just changed the angle a little bit, now it doesn't matter.
The thing is how big it is. It's still big.
Yeah, but it's not as big at all.
No, I know, but, like, look at this. I think, where were you guys thinking the tower would go?
Also could be angled like that.
Well, yeah.
And then it pivots around like that.
Or,
Yeah, but also make a smaller footprint.
Nah, not symmetrical.
Well, I don't think so. Not if we have it really light.
If we can, nah, we can fix that.
I just have more weight on one side.
But building an asymmetrical pickup would be kind of annoying.
Whatever. We did it this year. I mean, last year. Not the pickup itself, but other things.
No, just the lift. That was it.
Yeah.
No, no, no. I'm not talking. There's nothing wrong with it being asymmetrical, but it might be kind of tricky to build a pickup.
Yeah.
Ooh, what if we just used the same trough idea
as last year?
Yeah. And didn't, like, have any rotation to it. It just went back to the back.
Because it's got a dumbbell on the side.
We have an opening on the side. That would just. Well, obviously.
With that,
why don't we do that?
What?
Have a tractor beam.
What? Honestly, having an arm that does that wouldn't be the worst.
I just drew that and you said,
except it actually, in hindsight, that actually would be the worst.
Yeah, so we don't have to be all the way. Because, I mean, our drive base is like...
It's true.
No,
it's
I really like the auto-align function, though. That would be so cool.
Yeah, but at the same time, like...
won't work.
That wall would.
It's true, so...
Because if we drive our robot, like, kind of near the wall and we turn like that, wait. Aren't going to be all the way.
I have a brilliant idea.
Oh, boy.
It's for drive.
No!
Yeah, you know, honestly, this is a good year to have a holonomic.
Every year's a good year.
No, last year.
Yeah, last year was kind of shitty.
The year before.
That's why we built it last year.
Wow. But no, holonomic isn't like angled inwards.
Oh, so we just do that?
Yeah, quick, just undo everything.
Well, I mean, if we want to spin in circles. Primarily.
I mean... now I'm too low. I don't know. Have something fold down from the there. Okay, let's think about this.
That's a good idea.
I would rather just say...
We have something that folds down. So the front roller folds down, and then we have two more wheels that fold down from there. No, that's before.
What's the problem right now?
We want to get balls off of the wall.
Yeah.
We have a feeling that's the corner of the... This is the ramp.
Yeah.
And this is the wall.
Well...
And we have, or this is a corner, and there are balls in the corner, and we want to get them. And we can't drive like that.
Yeah, because then a pickup will be like here, and we'll be balls still.
And we don't really want to have to line right up next to the wall, because that's hard. So instead, we've decided to give up.
Yep.
Can we have something like going like this in the side?
That is a
thought. Yeah.
What ties on the side?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, well, we're probably gonna have
twister.
Well, I have a finger that goes like this.
No, like this.
Yeah. How about like this?
I mean, we're gonna have a like mechanism flip out with these rollers, and we're thinking of have those brushes, but those can't stick out.
That's not gonna work anyway.
Okay. Other than for those reasons, they can't stick out beyond 18.
Yeah.
So really, we need something to pivot out that way. So like a brush. I don't know why you're circling.
But how would that work? That couldn't really pivot out anyway. If we did have a brush, it would...
Exactly. I don't know. It'd serve the same purpose as this thing.
If we did have a brush, it would be here.
That won't help.
Yeah, I know.
Well...
I mean, it might.
Let's see. What's where?
Okay.
Yeah, larger than a Rubik's.
Here's something that might happen, Ian. What might happen is we might drive in, like, this is good. This is the correct one. We might drive in like this. Okay, ram into wall. And then sort of straighten out.
Yeah.
We just erased everything now.
That's okay, though.
Like, yeah. And then you sort of straighten out.
Yeah. Okay. And then this folds, like...
What is it?
Basically, here's our strategy.
We have a foam roller.
Ka-clunk.
No, we have men's horizontal rollers like that. And
that's
then
vertical. Anyway.
They hit things for
the horizon is horizontal.
But we called ours horizontal, whereas we called neutrinos vertical. Wait.
No. Maybe you did.
I did.
Last year our roller was vertical. And no, so was Neutrinos. Last year, all of them were horizontal last year.
Except that we had some going this way and some going this way.
Oh yeah, I forgot about those. Those ones were vertical. And then the horizontal ones were horizontal.
Okay, so we have two
I'm pretty sure I call it the opposite of that.
We have vertical rollers coming off the sides.
Like, I understand,
and
like...
And bevel gears?
That's vertical.
With a differential?
No, that's horizontal.
That's what I would thought.
Bevel gears are the differential. Yeah. Bevel gears are the differential.
Look that way.
Levi, is that a horizontal roller or a vertical?
Horizontal.
It goes that way, though, so I'll have to...
Yeah, but the roller is horizontal.
The axis.
Hence, it's a horizontal roller.
But the sides are vertical.
Well, whatever. Also, you just, like, clicked on something to get that ice cream. Anyway, so...
I was just thinking that ours last year were kind of like discs, and they were, like, horizontal to the ground.
Well, whatever, it doesn't matter. Strategy, though, we actually don't really... We could just have a thing.
We still want the helical thing, though.
Well, we have, like...
Is it a horizontal helical thing?
Oh, this whole thing would rotate around?
Well, that does require bevel gears.
And a differential.
A different... No.
Because it will be rotating in the opposite direction. Wow.
No, because if you have...
No, you're right, sweet.
Wait, no, it won't even need to do that. Like, it'll just do that.
Yeah.
And if that was the wrong direction, you just have it go to the other side. Yeah, but... Okay.
Okay, so let's talk
finally,
about...
Finally, Tetris bevel gears.
Nope. 3D print them.
Yeah, that was...
Go away.
No, wait, what?
We should use Tetris bevel
gears. No,
we should 3D print them.
They're so big.
No, that's the point.
No, bevel gears.
Anyway, you have this thing here. Is the idea that they sweep balls in... Is it spins like this? Because here's one thing, is that it's going to be shooting them out. Too. So is the idea that it's sweeping in them in like
this? I don't
this
know how the brushes are going to really affect it. Like, I don't know whether they'll shoot it this way, or whatever.
Honestly, I think it'd be better to do that.
Yeah, that's harder to rotate.
Also, it would maybe run into the wall. Yeah. It might just work to do this. But that also kill on wall.
Why would you have things go like this?
Well, why would it kill on the wall?
Because it's see where it is, and here's the wall.
Yeah, they're zip ties.
Oh, yeah.
This isn't like a razor blade.
That's a good point. So...
Oh, no!
That, it should be. That'd be funny. That would make the competition much more entertaining.
Already this competition seems like it's like going to be the most exciting.
Yeah.
Like, perspective.
So, we have... Thingy. I don't know, I'm just confused. I don't know exactly what this will do to the balls.
I don't either, like, I don't know where they'll go. They can go anywhere.
They actually kind of
I don't know, man, do you think they would go...
I don't think that's a good idea anymore.
Well, okay. here's
and there's large and small balls, too, so that's
large ball here, and we're driving here, and it's rolling, and it's just gonna go that way.
Yeah, but this is in the middle... Yeah, wait, what? We're just in the middle of the arena, driving backwards into a
ball. No, not driving backwards. Just driving.
We're driving like that. You're saying it doesn't, like, the ball doesn't go boom, it goes pshoo.
Probably.
Okay. But, I mean, with our current pickup, anything outside here isn't getting picked up anyways.
I think it'll probably go berserk. Honestly.
Yeah, like, I see. Yeah, it makes a lot more well, sense. One thing is, let's talk about scale. We could do this and then have... the front roller be much larger than these ones. So even if it does go like Herc, it still just goes straight into the...
That's even better. If it goes Herc.
It just goes straight into the thingies, the main rollers, which I'm conveniently shading for your convenience.
I think that the Helix thing would work. Like the original Helix thing.
The Helix thing is in the bin if we want.
Oh, the spiracular roller is the technical term.
Yeah, I guess that is the term now.
I just like this. Maybe we should call them spiraculous.
Where is it?
Okay. It's thing.
Here's the robot.
Yeah.
It's in the bin
somewhere, yeah.
Oh,
well,
that's a problem.
Good luck.
Wait, are we talking about the foam roller or the spiracular?
The spiracular. It's in, well, there's some chance you did take it out at one point yesterday.
Yeah, but I put everything in my house in that thing.
Wow.
Everything in my house.
Yeah,
tape roller. Oh,
yeah,
what?
I'm pretty sure it's in there.
So you want the ball on the wall, right? Like in the corner?
Yeah, well, I mean, pretty much we want to pick up as many balls as possible from any location. But the main problem is any balls that are along an edge or in a corner.
If you could have, like, a zip tie, like, a, you know, like, stack of zip ties on, like, a bar.
Yeah.
They have this, like, the robot go sideways, the balls will, like, come in this way.
Oh, that's interesting.
It's like, it could be, like,
so it'd
like,
be, like, we just have... Yeah, a like, zip tie brush here
yeah,
that just flips
like,
out, and then when we drive along it, it'll just plow them all
yeah.
at this corner. And then some of them will migrate over here
yeah.
to our pickup.
That's interesting.
Wait, what? What is it? Oh, it's just brushes.
Just zip ties like this.
Just zip ties like this. And
or, you know, kind of like a lever, except zip ties is safer.
And it just sort of nerf?
Yeah. Like, all the balls that are here will just go into this edge right here, and then we go rum.
Mm-hmm.
The problem is when they go in two little ones in there.
If they go,
we still don't have a very
yeah, if they
we
go
still
in the
don't
very
those.
Yeah,
not...
except that the point is that this zip tie brush is say like 2 inches, 3 inches long. When you drive up to the next to the wall, there's like one ball there.
That's a good point.
Like there's not gonna be a vertical tower.
Yeah.
Good action.
Oh,
well,
also,
that's good.
Then we can do this spiracular roller, which I'm all for, by the way.
I'm for them because they'd look really cool.
I know they look
and
really
no,
cool.
No, okay, they would actually have a very practical.
I think that's actually not a very good model.
No, it isn't at all.
They're way too stiff.
They should be long, and they should probably be
long.
Like a thick canvas or something like that.
How long is long?
Like
two,
this.
Five, ten.
Because they can't hit the little, or can they?
Well, we were debating that earlier.
Yeah.
But anyway, it should
and
go all the way to the edge.
And we decided that there.
They should go all the way to the edge. Like, as close as we can, like an eighth of an inch away from the edge.
Yeah.
So then it literally will take all the ones from the corners.
Honestly, I think that's the best plan.
It'd look really cool.
And I think it will work. I think there are ways to do arms.
Do you have zip ties in your house, Levi?
No.
But in terms of...
No.
In terms of just one thing with zip ties on it...
Simplicity-wise?
I mean,
this is, like, really simple.
Yeah, and I think it will work. The only thing
for
me is that
possibility of failure, which is like the biggest thing for me.
For me, it's that it might be a little too slow.
For me, it's all about the looks.
Electronics brainstorming starts now.
I just put those in a random spot because I needed to get them somewhere. But
I don't honestly that spot seems fine.
No, I agree. It just needs to be further.
We need
in.
Like
yeah.
three more, don't we? Oh wait.
Also, there's a question of where do we put the.
Formwork.
Everything else.
See, the problem with this it isn't that they're not like in a good spot there, but then this to put them any further back, the string will hit them.
That's interesting.
So,
really? Yeah.
Pretty much like this whole lift system is actually taking a whole lot of.
The thing I don't like about this is see how much the wires are going to have to bend as soon as they come out of the thing?
Yeah, I know. I know. So that's why I was thinking, that's why I thought that everything would just be on these side panels.
I'm the only person broken.
Yeah.
Okay, so we got NXT, battery, 8 controllers.
Yeah.
PT board. Samantha.
SP.
Samantha?
Control panel.
What's a Samantha?
That was funny.
There's a backronym. Wait, not backronym. What do you call this?
I don't know.
They, like, went in and added an actual...
Oh,
yeah, when you are a piece of shit. That's what I call those.
Anything else?
Is that John or Nathan or what?
And then we've got to have NXT...
I think there's the dogs, actually.
NXT and PT board on the same side.
Yeah.
And
then the guy who lives in
the
third house
the
doesn't like
and
golf.
The NXT should be close together.
That but the wire's long either way.
Yeah, but not the USB, though. We want the USB wire to be short, right?
Well, then we should buy one.
A short one?
Yeah.
Our current one's like 5 feet long.
But like...
That's
that
funny. I recall having a really short one a while ago.
Yeah, maybe.
Again.
And, yeah, we might as well get one. Okay.
Okay, so we can put a lot of electronics in the back.
Oh, I like that stacking thing. We should probably do that.
Are they directly
except
on
that's
top
not
of each
inside
other?
Of the robot.
Well, yeah, not
anymore. Also, yeah, they have to be offset so you can erase the screws.
Nah.
I like the idea
just magically
of having...
turn them with our minds.
That will also
okay,
match the slope of the thingy.
Really. Hello, we just had a few questions about the IR beacons. Are there one or two beacons?
What?
There will be two IR beacons.
What?
Our prayers have been answered. Hey, can you set up the field? Yeah. Yeah, we'll do that. Okay,
What is that?
The panels in here. The levee.
Yeah.
We got our... That'll be red. Why did you make the plexiglass red?
Yeah, I was wondering.
Oh, that's just to mark it, just so it like really stands out for when designing it.
So okay. You know it's
it was really annoying me. I kept hiding it.
I was like, why is the robot red?
Make it like a soothing greenish blue.
Make it goo colored.
I don't know. Well, here. Levi.
Yeah.
So, cable chain. Now I'm thinking maybe it should go on the back.
What the heck?
I thought it was going to go in the center.
I thought it was going to go on one side.
I thought it was going to go on the center.
It can't go on the center.
No.
Why not?
It hits stuff.
Even in autonomous.
But I thought, I mean, isn't the wire going to come up through there?
It's coming out this back. There's going to be a little hole.
Oh, okay. And that'll go up through the thing.
Okay, like, actually, this cat is the worst. Like, this stuff that they did, the resource
things.
Because the holes aren't right.
Like,
okay, so these two holes are spaced differently than these two holes.
Wait,
just, I'm pretty sure because I was having constraint issues.
That's pretty derpy.
Yeah.
Who are we trusting?
Yeah, first. Third. I don't know why we keep doing that.
Okay.
That's pretty weird. I don't know.
Yeah. So if you drive off the ramp, onto the floor, and then back onto the ramp, you don't get any points for driving off the ramp. You don't get the 20 points.
Wait.
I don't know why you'd ever do that.
So if you just sit on the ramp for the whole match, you get 30 points, right?
Huh? Yes.
Wait, why don't we do that?
Okay, this is actually the worst cat ever. Okay, look at this. You can constrain one of these holes.
Oh, you can't even record video on a phone from the driver's station. That's
yeah, cool. I know. I've known that. I've seen like a zillion people doing that, though.
Wow, whatever. Levi, cable chain on the back of the robot?
Okay, so...
Like, I mean, we got our two lift segments here, and then we got this plate here.
Yeah.
That's the front.
Oh, I was thinking, if we go back here, this part right here, this part would have a little panel going directly down, because that just allows for the tube to go through. The tube to wobble in.
Oh, you mean you have a plate behind that?
Yeah, plate going down like that.
Yeah, okay.
And then we have the cable chain mounted to that.
I was thinking... So the wires are going to be coming out of a hole in this plate.
Uh-huh.
And then we just have attached from one corner, it dangle down and attached to this.
Okay.
And you go like that.
Yeah, that works.
I think the first thing we need to worry about is positioning of these guys.
Yeah.
No, like, are they right? Because you were like...
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, they're right. Just like, over you what you want.
Huh?
What? Okay, hold on.
Blue LEDs take more voltage than you can.
Oh, wait, I know what it is. There's a mouse in the robot.
Okay, turn that way. It's this front wheel right there.
The Omni wheel?
Yeah.
I hope we're not like... Well, I wasn't electrocuted.
Okay, let's lower the lift.
I think this was you, Tobin.
Yeah, well, because I just manually did it back.
Oh, shoot, we don't have safety tiles.
And it doesn't reset automatically when it lowers.
That's way too far.
What are you doing?
Way too
change it back to...
Is there like a thing where we can?
There we go. That's good.
Yeah, that's fine.
No, just kidding. That's the wall.
It needs to have safety. Then.
Like, no, actually, you can do it. You can do it. No.
No.
That's the wrong way.
I'm pretty sure I'm just doing like one.
Okay, just lower it. Just lower it.
Okay. We're gonna flip the robot now.
Okay.
That's not how you flip the robot.
Tried.
It is true though, Ernest. We probably need to have like manual centering.
Things should happen. We're out of buttons.
No, automatic centering.
Okay.
Oh, we should have manual centering too. whatever. Forget about manual centering. Manual centering.
Oh, I know what the issue is.
Oh no.
It's really funny too. You guys are gonna think it's funny.
Oh, something's hitting the wheel?
No, the plastic is probably hitting the ground.
Oh,
like, oh, because it's so heavy.
Yeah, because it's so heavy, the plastic part.
That is totally.
Oh, I'm sure that's what's happening too.
Okay, what do we do? Duct tape on each of these.
That's the cannon wheel, so wait.
WD-40 on our wheel.
What do you think?
Honestly,
the robot,
how much of a problem is it?
No, really? It's from.
Well,
it turns slower.
The real problem is static.
It doesn't turn very well.
And that.
Should we try putting a loop of duct tape on?
We should go like that one team did and like drill holes all over our robot.
Or we could.
I don't remember any teams doing that to our robot.
What if we like filed these?
I thought about it.
Oh, that's actually. Pretty dumb.
Bad, but also, like, what else is there?
It could work.
Why do we even need the plastic?
Gosh darn it. See, I think our robot is heavier.
Yeah, probably a little bit.
Seems like it.
Can we try taking something off of the robot?
Ooh, no. Lift!
No.
Yeah, no.
Okay, so weight is actually an issue right now?
Yeah. God damn it. I never thought this would happen.
Okay,
That's funny.
So,
how heavy is it, Ian?
I don't know, but I think
it's. Do you have a scale in your house?
Mine says.
It doesn't have batteries, but.
Mine
like,
says it weighs.
We have batteries.
62 okay. pounds. So
what?
It's wrong.
Okay, so I think that we should try filing these down.
I don't have a file.
The thing about filing is that it risks making the surface, like, worse. And then I don't know about that.
This is a terrible idea.
Okay.
I know someone who won't like the idea, but okay. Do they sell 3-inch on the emails?
Oh no.
You were the first to have
3-inch on the
emails. I thought about that earlier, actually.
I don't know.
I think, I mean, the thing is we don't have time for that.
Yeah. Got rid of our scale.
What?
Because they ran out of batteries.
She was probably like,
you don't
us are fat.
Sell things when they run out of batteries. If we did that, we would not have this robot.
Ian? That just happened?
No. That
no.
Was the, okay.
No, that was when I threw the small ball. Okay, well, for now, let's just ignore that problem. Yeah.
Let me know.
That's really wait, no, funny. None of my controls work.
Yeah.
Yeah, but now we're not gonna do center call.
Okay, that's fair.
Let me download some code and see if this
works. Okay, see if it works. And if it doesn't fix it, then Ian and I will play a match and you can look at your code some more. And
I'm going to.
It's pretty annoying for turning.
Yeah, but honestly, for right now, we are just gonna ignore that.
Wait, can we just try putting duct tape on each of these?
That's so
do you mean on it, the wheels?
On the wheels. So make them like
one
way. Yeah. That's so bad.
The other thing you have to keep in mind. The other thing you have to keep in mind is that this might not be a problem on newer mats.
That's possible.
It's a bit of a long like that's not exactly what I want to depend on.
Or
but.
Newer mats might be squishy.